is only 5 days until New Year's Eve, but it is not too late to plan the perfect party.
That's right. Cathie Fillion is here from DIY's Do-It-Yourself Network's Creative Juice, and she's going to show us how. Hi, Cathie.
Hello.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Thanks for being here.
By the way, I'm standing up on a step. I'm not that tall.
Yeah.
All right.
That's the reality.
Yeah.
Okay. I got to get back to my hole.
All right.
I am this short.
No, no. Go ahead.
So we've got some great ideas, and basically we're starting with signage. So anytime you're having a New Year's Eve party, or really all these ideas can go for any type of party, you want to open the party with signage. If you're living in an apartment or a condo, it's a great idea, so direct people know how to get to your party.
Mm-hmm. I love that. That is so cute, and obviously it's something you can just make yourself, right?
Yep, that's just a piece of foam core board and a whole bunch of glitter and everything thrown up onto there.
Sure, you can use your leftover holiday decorations to do
There's
it.
There's a lot of leftover holiday decorations here for
so
our centerpiece.
This is a centerpiece.
Yep. We've got tons of This is actually Christmas decorations here, scrapbook papers mixed in there. We're kind of going for a bohemian chic theme. So all different kinds of stuff. Got a very inexpensive vase, and we just wrapped it with a piece of scrapbook paper to create those stripes.
Perfect. And then, now tell me about this. And all of this stuff, it's kind of special because you could actually involve, Guy and I were saying we never have our kids to New Year's.
Oh. No.
We always go out or do something, but they could help you plan it and hear about it.
Yeah, absolutely. And there's lots of great ideas here for kids, and they can help make them too.
Right, right.
So the next thing is party wear. If you're going to have a large party or a small party, depending upon that, there's a couple of options. These are just very inexpensive glasses that we etched with glass etching cream. You can pick it up at any craft store. Just use some stickers to put 2007 there.
I was going to ask you, is it a good idea to get, you know, plastic? Because, you know, by midnight, I don't know if I want anybody holding like crystal stuff at midnight, especially at a party I'm throwing.
Yeah. Exactly. So, you know. Well, if you are going to go the plastic route, and if you're having a lot of guests, this is a great idea. Just go ahead and add a little bit of fluff to them.
Sure.
And I like to hot glue the base to the glass. That way you don't get any spillage during your party.
Oh, that makes a big difference. That's a great idea.
That's just some marabou feathers, and then we've got some fun little trinkets around there.
Let's go over to Namwa. Did you have an idea, Nam?
Well, actually, yeah. You were talking about getting kids involved before, and we had an email that goes to that point, which says, for family parties, it's hard for people to get babysitters. So what are some tips for keeping small children occupied while the parents are enjoying the party?
I love that. We always have that question.
I can't even hear it.
Let me tell you what she said. For people with small kids, what do you do? And do you have any ideas for keeping them occupied during the party? Because we never have a babysitter, so we always have a party at home.
We've got some fun ideas. The first one is giving them activities like this countdown clock, which is just made from a recycled record album.
Cute.
We use guitar picks to be the numbers there.
Very cool.
These are punch and toss. They're made with a bridal shower favor like this, just a plain champagne glass. You can fill it with confetti. Then the kids can punch them and have their own toast that way.
Very nice.
And these fun bubbles. Look how cute these are. These are just store-bought bubbles.
All right.
And these are just tags, right, from the office supply store.
And now these are hats and whistles and stuff that you made yourself.
Fun.
Because they get expensive.
These are, both of these hats here are just done with one sheet of scrapbook paper, one 12 by 12, and you just form it into a cone shape, and then just glue all sorts of bits and bobbles on them.
Cute.
This one was a store-bought one, but I just added some fun, you know, glittery fringe to it
Butterfly.
And some feathers.
Cute.
Butterfly found that in my Easter box, so
these
I love just throwing all sorts of stuff together like
Absolutely.
That. We've got the hangover cure kit, which is definitely not for the kiddos.
Yeah.
But that's a great party favor for your guests. It's got aspirin and gum.
Why is everybody looking at me? you're all looking at me. It's a hangover kit and you're
that's
looking at me.
That's for you, Guy.
That's not right. So what about, and I see you've got my glass here.
Yeah, these are some inspiration fortunes for 2007. And we have one for everybody in the audience today.
Yes, everybody gets their own little fortune.
Crew at Creative Juice helped put them together. And they're just really fun. They're just done with a punch like this. They're very simple, and you can pick up most of these supplies at either craft store or office supply store. These are just some stickers here.
Cool.
And then you go in, rubber stamp them, and then just print your 2007
this
or any message.
Great ideas.
Great ideas.
Thank
great
you
ideas.
So much.
Cathie, thanks so much for being. Give Cathie a hand, everybody.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. And by the way, you can see a lot of her other great ideas on her show. It's called Creative Juice, and it's on 5 days a week on the DIY Network.
Yeah.
Thanks for being here.
Thank you.
Fantastic.
Hey, so cute.
We will be right back, everybody. Stay tuned. You're watching iVillage Live.